Hi everyone. Right, I just want to share something with you. You know I don't just love, I adore elegance. And I really do. And look what I've just made. I hate bows, but this is one easy way of making a beautiful bow. And I've used a cream satin, a glass domed French cabochon, and some gathered lace, and I've put a pin on the back as well. And then on this one, I've also done, again, the lace around, added a bit of bling that was an earring with a bit of pearl, and the cabochon, cameo. And I'm gonna show you how to do them. They are so quick, so easy. Would pass as lovely gifts, as brooches on your bags, wherever you want to put them. And I just think they're stunning. And you know me, I'll always try and do something that's a little bit different. So I'm going to show you that and how to make them right now. You're going to need some ribbon. I've got an old earring because you don't have to put a cameo in. This is going to look fantastic, like a flower inside a bow, on top of a bow. Now, you do need a flamethrower of some sort. I call them flamethrowers, you know what I mean. Needle and thread. Unfortunately, you do. But easy. Couple of stitches, that's all. You're going to need about 25 centimetres of ribbon on that size bow. Sorry, I'm losing my needle and thread there. Let me just pop that out of the way. Done that, and I need the blood. So I'm just doing about 25 centimetres. You need them to be same. As much as possible, and then you need one about 6.5 centimetres. And this is how quick it is. All you do, take your flamethrower, your lighter, candle, whatever it is you use, and just burnish the edge really quick on the smallest piece, and then you pleat that. Just put a pleat in it, and if you're careful, as it melts, squash it down. And just to check it's done, do that. That's it, done. Then where you've pleated it one way, pleat it the opposite way. You could leave it as is, but because I am covering something with it, it just gives you that, when the glue sticks, it sticks into there and it firms, you know, holds it firmly. Take your other two pieces, burnish the edges really quick. Like I said, this is a... No, don't do this to me. Trust it! Trust it! Just let me fill it up again. Oh, come on. It doesn't want to. Why doesn't it want to fill up? Have I got it right? Yes. That should be enough. It is. It'll do. Where was I? You know, flamethrower now. See, that's why I call it a flamethrower. Just do the edges really quickly. And then what you do is cross them over. Do one at a time. I've left about a centimetre for me to sew there. And you need to get that roughly in the middle. Take your needle and thread, and this is the back side of it. Go in, out, and do a running stitch right the way across. This is so easy. And, you know, we're probably going to see these all over the place because they are so easy. Pull that in. Sorry. Just wrap your cotton round a few times. Take your needle. Poke that back through. And snip that off, quick as that. And then all you do is you pull out best you can, like that, and that's it. So do that to both of them. You can see through the material how far you've got it, and you do need it roughly in the middle. Oops, sorry, I need to put a knot in mine. But like I say, they are so quick and easy to make. These aren't the bows I have problems with. It's the bow maker ones, you know those, and I can't stand them. They do me head in. I've bought several bow makers. But these are quick and easy, and I can do these any day. So wrap that round a few times, poke the needle straight through again. I'm just going to do that again, because that seemed to go through a little bit easy. Okay, and then what you do is, while that's on, take the other one. Make sure you've got them the right way. That's the back side of it. I'm going to thread mine through. Like that. Wrap the two together. And then pop the needle back through. You do have to be careful. So I'm using the big needles here. I'm only doing it the once. Snip that off. Right, so that'll do. I'm quite happy with those. Take this bit, pop it in the middle, turn it upside down, move them out of the way, and just run your glue gun across the top of that. And then move your bow out of the way and flick that over. That's all you need to do. It's just giving it a base for the whatever it is you're going to set on it. Somewhere for it to sit. Okay, so we've got that. Now, all you do with your bow is you pull that like that. Beautiful, isn't it? Nice bow. Now, to do the middle bit, all I'm doing is using a bit of gathered lace that I'm going to gather again just to make the central bit. So you can make this like a flower. Okay. And this depends, the amount you need for this just depends how much you want your gathered flower to be gathered. I'd probably do around about 6 inches, something like that. Let's gather that up. But like I say, these are stunning. They will look fantastic on a box somewhere. Do them in any colour you like. Coming up, for when it's Valentine's and things like that, Easter, do your little bows. Put your little bits, you can put a little chick in the middle. It doesn't have to be bling, it doesn't have to be a cameo. It could be anything you want it to be. Go with a theme. If you're doing a gothic, something for, gothic-y, you can use, I've got Blackbird cameos. Use one of those for the centre. So it's completely up to you. Right, so what I'm going to do now is pull this flower together. Sorry, I got that tangled a bit. It's because it's gathered. Take that end, meet the end with that one. So you're joining both ends together. Give it a pull, so you're gathering this flower. I think my grandsons are going home in a minute, so I wanted to get this done quickly. Just give it a really good tack. Snip that off. I always open mine up and glue that. I do sometimes stitch them, but there's no need for all of that. It doesn't make any difference. This way you don't see any stitching, so it's a bit more professional looking. Right, there's the flower. Okay, so take the flower, pop on the glue, pop it on the centre, gather that round where you need it. I'm going to take the flower, the centre thing that I'm going to use for the flower, with the centre of that. Isn't that stunning? Look at that. I can hang lace from it, beads from it, or whatever I want to do. I'm making mine into a pin. And so all I'm going to do is just put a little bit of glue around that. And these are so quick and easy to make. Push that down so the glue comes through the two holes and then let that set. And there you go. Let me just pop my needle away. My scissors. My flamethrower. Move the ruler. And we'll share them. There we go. Stunning. Or what? Thanks for watching. Take care. And I'll speak to you soon. Bye bye for now.